Hello students, in this video we will talk about classification, taxonomic categories, taxonomic hierarchy. In the previous videos, we learned about identification and nomenclature. Now let's see what is classification. Classification is grouping of organisms into convenient categories on the basis of those characters which are easily observable. Classification is important because a living world consists of millions of organisms, so it is extremely difficult to study all of them individually. Since classification is putting organisms into specific categories, these categories are termed as taxa. Taxa includes categories like cats, fish, frogs, birds, etc. When we classify an organism, it involves hierarchy of steps, where each step corresponds to a category, a rank, or a taxon. So the position of taxon in the hierarchical classification of an organism is termed as taxonomic category. So the organisms which are closely related to one another are placed together in a group. The groups which have similarities with each other then are combined to form larger groups. Such similar larger groups will now combine to form even a little more larger ones, and so on and so forth it continues, thus building the taxonomic category. These taxonomic categories come together to form taxonomic hierarchy. Well, when we look at each category of taxonomic hierarchy, it is a distinct unit of classification called as taxon. So then, how would one define a taxon? Taxon is a group of organisms which are genetically related and have common characters within them, but have distinct characters from those of other groups. Example, all fishes can form a taxon, all birds can come together to form another taxon, lichens as well can form another taxon. The taxonomic categories are distinct biological entities. They are not just morphological similar looking bodies. The taxonomic categories are arranged either in a descending or ascending order, constituting the taxonomic hierarchy, which is also called as Linnaean hierarchy. The seven major categories are kingdom, phylum or division, class, order, family, genus and species. All these seven are termed as obligate categories, and any given species can be traced to these seven categories. Among all these seven, kingdom is the highest and species is the basic or smallest category. Highest rank, that is kingdom, shows less similarity among organisms in them, while species show more similarities. So as we discussed earlier, the seven major categories are kingdom, phylum, division, class, order, family, genus, and species, kingdom being the highest and species being the lowest category. When we classify individual or group of organisms into a particular category, what is important? It is very important to study all the similar and dissimilar characters of that organism. Let's take an example of housefly, which is already shown in the slide. The scientific name of housefly is Musca domestica. It is included in the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Diptera, family Muscidae, genus Musca, and species Domestica. This is how a taxonomical hierarchy of an organism is represented. So when you look at this slide, you find two pyramids. The first one is an inverted pyramid of the seven categories. It is inverted because as you go from species to kingdom, the number of organisms goes on increasing, as well as diversity and complexity within the organism also goes on increasing from species to kingdom. But in the other pyramid, relationship among organism goes on increasing from kingdom to species along with its specificity. So now let's look at obligate categories individually. Let's start with the lowest rank, that is species. It is a basic unit in biological classification. The term species was coined by John Ray. The biological concept of species was given by Ernest Mayr. According to Ernest Mayr, species is a group of closely related individuals with similar morphological, anatomical, biochemical characters. They also share a common gene pool with their ancestors. They can interbreed in nature and produce fertile offsprings. They are reproductively isolated and genetically closed system. Example, when you write mango or Mangifera indica, Mangifera is a generic name and indica is a specific epithet. But apart from this, there are few exceptions to it. Example, mule, a hybrid of male horse and female donkey, and hinny, a hybrid of female horse and male donkey. Horse and donkey can breed in wild. Both their offsprings, that is mule and hinny, are sterile. Let's take one more example. Tigon, a hybrid of tiger and lioness, and liger, a hybrid of lion and tigress. Tigons and ligers can be produced only in captivity, but in them, the females are fertile while males are sterile, so they cannot be considered as a biological species. As we climb up to the taxonomical hierarchy, we move on to the next group after species, which is genus. Similar group of species are put in one genus. So genus is a group of related species which has high or increased characters in common amongst them compared to species of other genera. For example, lion, the scientific name of lion is Panthera leo, leopard is Panthera pardus, tiger is Panthera tigris. In this, different species belong to the same genus Panthera. Why are they belonging to the same Panthera genus? Because they share some common characters. But they differ from another genus called as Felis, which belongs to cats. In case of plants, potato and brinjal, both belong to the same genus Solanum. Genera can be further divided as monotypic genera and polytypic genera. Monotypic genera is the one with only one species. Example, Jingo biloba. Jingo biloba, which is a only living species of Jinko phyta, is also referred to as a living fossil. Eritmochelys imbricate, a hawksbill critically endangered sea turtle, is also another example of monotypic genera. In case of polytypic genera has many species. For example, Canis genus has many species like Canis familiaris, that is dog, Canis lupus, that is wolf, and Canis aureus, that is jackal. So the next one is family. It is a group of related genera with less number of common characters as compared to genus and species. In case of plants, the family name ends with a suffix A-C-E-A-E, like Fabiaceae, while the subfamily ends with O-I-D-E-A-E, Mimosoidae. And in case of animals, the family name ends with a suffix I-D-A-E, Felidae. Subfamily ends with I-N-A-E, Pantherinae. Let's take an example for plants. Related genera like Solanum, Petunia, Datura and Atropa belong to one family, Solanaceae. While in case of animals, Panther and Felis genera are put together in one family, that is Felidae. The next one is order. Similar families are put in one order. So order basically has less number of common characters as compared to family, genus, species. In plants, the order name ends with A-L-E-S, that is rosales. While in case of animals, different suffixes are used. There is no specific suffix in case of animals. If you look at the slide, the Felidae family of cats and Canidae family of dogs both are put in one order, that is order Carnivora. So the next group is class. It is a group of related orders. The name of class in plants, especially with algae, ends with a suffix phyce. So chlorophyce or opsida, which is bryopsida. In animals, order primates, which include animals like monkey, gorilla, human, and order carnivora, which includes tiger, cat, and dogs, are put in one class, that is mammalia. The suffix for classes as well is not fixed in case of animals. As we move towards the highest category, we come to the next group, that is phylum. Phylum includes many classes with common characters. In animals, classes like pisces, amphibia, reptilia, aves, mammalia are put in one phylum, that is phylum chordata. Due to some common features like presence of notochord in life stage, dorsal nerve cord, and presence of gill slits. In plants, this category is named as division and generally ends with a suffix phyta. For example, bryophyta, pteridophyta. The final and the highest category in taxonomic hierarchy is kingdom. It is a group of phyla or division with less related organisms present in it. The phyla, which lacked cell wall and chlorophyll, were placed in kingdom Animalia, while all divisions of plants with rigid cell wall and presence of chlorophyll were put under the kingdom Plantae. According to the five kingdom classification, kingdom is divided into five groups: kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and kingdom Animalia. We would be elaborating on these classification systems in the future videos. In the next video, we would be discussing about taxonomical aids. Thank you.